ADHD. Effects on relationships. Understanding and loving your partner with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Defusing conflicts and misunderstandings. Written by Jessica Gray. Narrated by Robyn Mary Bouedo. Introduction. My mission is to help the partners of people who have ADHD, or who they suspect might have it. I'm going to begin by telling two stories. Can you relate to the partner who doesn't have ADHD? The first story is specifically for female readers. Is this person like you? You make yourself a cup of coffee, sit down at the kitchen table, and feel like crying. Then you push the mug aside and hammer the table with your fists and scream, with no one to hear you. He's gone off again to buy materials for a new DIY project. A project that came into his head only yesterday. Meanwhile, the house and the garden outside look like a building site. Everywhere there's a project on the go. New paving for the path outside, half completed, so you have to finish your journey to the gate over the muddy earth. A column for the covered veranda, the roof and other three columns yet to appear. A wall in the kitchen with no tiles on it, plastered, but the tiles you bought him with your money are still in boxes because they aren't the right size and must go back someday. Now he wants to put a sink outside at the back of his mum and dad's house. They tell him they'll pay him when he's finished. They know their son. Your money, his and yours, is tight. And you've just found out you're pregnant. Your funny, humorous, hyperactive husband does know this. But has it sunk in that babies cost money? His parents also know, but it hasn't stopped them from accepting his offer to put in that sink. He just can't sit still, and nothing seems to hold his attention for long. You can't sit on the sofa and watch a film together. Well, you can, but he will be looking at his phone for half of the time. And then when you make a remark, "Villain, con man, he deserved that," your husband will look confused and say, "I didn't know he was the one behind it all." Your husband can't follow any long, complicated story. You see his eyes flicker, look sideways, or just glaze over after 30 seconds. In the end, you have such an argument with him that afterwards you ask him to go to marriage counseling. He looks a little hurt, but agrees. The two of you both feel stressed, and that you aren't on the same wavelength. The counselor asks a lot of questions and came out with a shocking opinion. Your husband might have ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. It kind of makes sense. He admits that he was totally hyperactive as a child. The counselor cautions you both that she isn't qualified to diagnose it, but that she could put you in contact with someone who can. So you go to a psychologist. After she holds a long interview with your husband, has an interview with you, and you and his parents have all completed questionnaires, the psychologist agrees. He has ADHD. He isn't sure what to make of it. There are plans to start counseling, and maybe to see a doctor for medication. Then he just forgets about all of this, and his eyes light up with a DIY project. Another DIY project. You ask yourself, what does this ADHD mean? And what hope is there for our relationship? I want to share with you that there is hope. You can and need to understand ADHD, and through doing so, your husband. He needs to accept that he has it. He needs to understand himself, and he must learn new skills. ADHD is going to be with him for life, but he can overcome it and live a much more peaceful, focused, and productive life. Your relationship can be happier, more romantic, and you can work, love, and laugh together. This is a book for partners of people who have ADHD. About 2/3 of diagnosed sufferers of ADHD are men or boys. But contrary to what popular opinion thinks, we know that ADHD affects women and girls as well. A not-so-insignificant number of people go undiagnosed and misunderstood through life. The point of this book is to not give a professional diagnosis, but to help you after your partner has been diagnosed. Also, if you suspect that he or she has ADHD, I can give you many things to think about. You will need medical and psychological help to be certain of it, but knowing what it is and how it affects someone can help you not make mistakes and blame him or her or yourself unnecessarily. Let's take a look at the second story. You are the male partner of a woman who has ADHD, or who's suspected of having it. Is this man like you? You love your free-spirited hippie girlfriend. She also drives you crazy. When she's happy and focused on something interesting, like art or sustainable living, she's inspiring. At parties or gatherings, she socializes with everyone. She's artistic and has a good sense of humor. Alas, she's the most unpractical woman you know. She could suggest to you excitedly that the two of you go to the forest park in the mountains for a picnic. You get ready, taking the food and drink and some raincoats in case it rains. As you sit there looking up at the mountainous splendor, eating your sandwiches, she says, "Can we climb that mountain? The view up there must be amazing."
"Climb up there? You're not serious," you say.
"But there must be a path or some kind of trail. We could go halfway at least." "It must be 3,000 feet up to the top, and there's snow."
"Can't we try? Just go for a walk as far as the snow."
"Jillian, you're crazy. We're wearing canvas shoes, and we only have raincoats, no jerseys."
You come home from work one day after driving through the rain for hours, and there is Jillian, sitting making dream catches, feathers and thread all over the place.
"Hi, home at last."
You talk together for a while, but you are totally starving, and there's no aroma of food.
"Tell me, what's for supper? Do you need to heat it up?"
"Supper?
Oh, sorry, I forgot."
You are a modern boyfriend who believes in sharing chores equally. You cook and clean, wash and hang out the clothes, all the rest. Yet this was Jillian's turn to cook. It's too late to buy a takeaway meal, which neither of you like because you know what's in them. And you're in no mood to wait for her to cook, or to help her, which you'd need to do to speed things up. Sandwiches again. Nagging, so she doesn't forget things or events, and sighing with frustration, when she does yet again, is something you are learning to get used to. As is the fact that she usually interrupts you, and often doesn't finish what she says, leaving you to guess what she is thinking. Jill has another side which is darker and more troubling. Sometimes she becomes depressed and irritable, withdrawn and negative about the world and herself. She says she feels like committing suicide. It hurts you to see it. Then she goes off and takes drugs. You can't stay home all night or all day and police her. You know soon enough when she's taken something. Her personality becomes extroverted and over the top. Hysterical laughter, talking non-stop, making no sense at times. After a few hours, her spirits sink, and she may end up depressed again, shouting, raging, and smashing things. After that, she sleeps as if she were almost dead, and wakes up to give you floods of tears and apologies. Jill once went to a party in her excited state, without you, and got in trouble with the police when they raided the premises and found drugs. You gave it to her afterwards, saying how you were ashamed of her. More hysterics followed. A few days later, and she's back to her usual happy, absent-minded, charming self. Is she bipolar? There isn't any definite cycle, just random depression and overexcited episodes followed by chaos, which occurs when she takes drugs. At times, you say Jillian catches dreams like hooking a great white shark, or else she sits there and catches nothing. Your family doesn't like her. You wonder if you should ever have children together.
When you think about breaking up, it makes you fear that she'd take her life if you did. Finally, she agrees with you that she should try taking antidepressants. Your doctor thinks it's a possibility, but wants an evaluation first. The psychiatric and psychological opinion comes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.